In the past lecture, we have seen sequences of numbers, and we have talked about what does it mean for a sequence of numbers to converge. And we have also looked at functions and what does it mean for a function to be continuous. And now we bring the two things together by looking at sequences of functions and looking of ways in which sequences of functions can converge. And there are two basic notions of convergence which are really important in all of mathematics, but in particular now in calculus, which is point-wise convergence, which is a reasonably weak version of convergence, and uniform convergence, which is much stronger and implies nice properties. Let us look at this. So now we consider functions that go from some, sorry, the functions are called, how did I call them, fn. They go from some domain in R, again to the real numbers. D is some subset of R. Of course, you can define this in more general spaces, but for simplicity, I just write it down for the real numbers. And now I want to say, what does it mean that the sequence converges point-wise? We say that the sequence fn, n in n, converges point-wise to f, also a function that goes from the domain to R, if for all x in our domain, we know that fn of x converges to f of x. Okay, so when we evaluate the function at a particular point x, the function's fn, then the sequence of numbers that we get converges to the evaluation of the function f at the same point. So maybe just as a bit of intuition, so if we define xn to be fn of x, and we define, how do I define this now, y to be f of x. Maybe this is not a consistent way. I define yn being the function value fn evaluated at x and y the function f evaluated at x. Then we have essentially yn converges to y in the way we usually define convergence of sequences, because these are now real numbers. Okay, and this is point-wise, so we need to know that it does converge for each point, but we don't know anything essentially about how fast they converge. Let me maybe consider a couple of examples. Here I have the functions fn, and f are always supposed to go from the interval 0, 1 to r. And I define fn of x to be the function x to the power of 1 over n. And let's maybe make a drawing. So if we have f1, so this is just the function x, it looks like this. If we have the square root function for 2, it looks like this. Well, this is not a nice drawing. Let's try it a bit better. Maybe this way. And then we have for a higher n, it always looks a bit... Well, they're not supposed to decrease, but you know how the square root function looks like. So this was for n equals 1. N equals 2, n equals 3, and so on. So this is how all these functions look like. And now you can already imagine what they converge to. They converge to the function fx, which is 0 if x is 0, and 1 otherwise. Observe that we just define the function on the interval 0, 1, so we don't need to care about what happens with negative numbers or anything like that. Anyways, this is what the limit is. And I guess you can, I hope that all of you would be able to prove formally that these functions really converge. Point-wise, so what you need to prove is that for every x, if you take x to the power of 1 over n and you look at the limit for n to infinity, this converges either to 0 or 1 as we have just written it down. This example also shows that if you have a sequence of functions and all these functions are continuous, it does not automatically imply that the limit function is continuous as well, at least under this notion of point-wise convergence. So I make a little attention sign here. If fn converges to f point-wise and all fn are continuous, this does not imply that f is continuous. And this is just the example we have seen, because this limiting function f is of course not continuous at zero. Okay, and so from a mathematical point of view, this is a bit of an annoying fact, and there are many other properties that are not being preserved if you have this point-wise convergence. And this is why we often consider a stronger notion of convergence, which is called the uniform convergence. Let us look at it. So we have, how did I do it? So here we have convergence point-wise, and now we want to make the definition, maybe let's put a definition here. And now we put the definition for converging uniformly. Fn, the sequence, under the same assumption as before, converges to f uniformly. So converges uniformly, and the uniformly is here now the important word, if we have the following property. I just write it down formally. For all epsilon larger than zero, there exists some n, a natural number, like again this index beyond which everything is nice, such that if we are beyond this index, so n is larger than capital N, we have for all x in the domain where the function is defined, fn of x minus f of x is smaller than epsilon. And now what is the difference here? The difference is now that this for all x in x, let me just make this in red. Again, it's in the middle, like after we have fixed epsilon, so someone gives us epsilon, then you need to fix n such that for all points in your domain, this distance requirement holds. And this uniform convergence would again be for all your points in the domain, like you would move this this for all statement here. If you would move this here to the front, then you would have the point-wise convergence. It's a bit like when we looked at the sequences, we had convergence and uniform convergence. It's a similar kind of phenomenon here. And maybe just one intuition. Let me just write it down. Intuition. So let me just draw this figure. So we have here some function f. So this is going to be the limiting function. And the idea is now we can fit a little epsilon cube around this function. So someone gives us epsilon. And then we look at this epsilon cube. This is epsilon, the distance here. And eventually, the functions fn are going to be contained completely in this tube. So I maybe draw one example of this fn. So this might be fn. And this fn function is now if this index n is high enough, this fn function is completely contained in this epsilon tube. And this is what is meant by you. Of course, we would need to have many of these red functions, but eventually, given any epsilon, eventually there is a large index n, such if we look beyond this index, then these functions are contained in this epsilon tube. And this would not be the case, maybe let's go back to this uniform convergence example here, because if we would look at this uniform, let's maybe draw this once more, so maybe I just write a bit of text. Uniform convergence means given epsilon, there exists n such that all fn with n larger than n are contained in the epsilon tube. This is what I just said. This is uniform convergence. And now maybe look at a different example, the one we just had previously, these kind of square root functions. the limiting function looks like this. It is zero, or maybe I should use the same color scheme as before, sorry, that's bad. How should I do that? Maybe I make this, in fact, I mark the function we are converging to in yellow. It's not better, isn't it? Sorry. I just don't know how to do it in such a way that you can easily see it. Let's try it once more, but with a smaller pen, like this. Yes, that's better. So this yellow guy is this limiting function f. And now here, our yellow guy is going to be the point zero here and the line one here. And now we are on the interval 0, 1. So here we have 0, here we have 1. And so the square root function, the red guys, always look like this. Maybe in the beginning, maybe I should put 1 a bit. This isn't really symmetric. Let's put 1 here, sorry. Now let's plot the square root functions. So this is maybe the square root. And then it increases more and more, like this. So this is the higher n goes, the more sort of they squeeze into the corner. But if I now fit an epsilon tube around this function, around this yellow function, here essentially the tube would be this. And you see that close to zero, there are always going to be some points on the red curve which are not yet in the blue, in this blue band around the function. So maybe I write it here. I'm close to zero. There will always be points x close to zero such that the red functions fn of x are not yet, not yet in the epsilon tube. And this is why this is not uniformly convergent. Not uniformly convergent. But it converges pointwise. And in fact, we always have, if something converges uniformly, it of course converges pointwise, but not the other way around, otherwise we wouldn't need to make this definition. Okay, and maybe two more other remarks. You can also define what uniformly convergence means if you look at the infinity norm. So we have seen the infinity norm in linear algebra or functional analysis. So alternate definition. Fn converges to F uniformly if and only if the infinity norm of Fn minus F converges to zero. So if you measure the distance between two functions in infinity norm, remember, the infinity norm says we look at all points in the space and we look at how far is the distance between these fn of x and f of x, and we take the supremum over this. And in the supremum norm, did I say infimum norm earlier? I wanted to say, norm with the infinity sign, but supremum norm. This is equivalent to saying it converges uniformly. Okay. And the most important theorem that we have about uniformly converging series of functions is that uniform convergence preserves continuity. Let me write it down. So the statement in words is uniform convergence preserves continuity. So this is what it means in words, but let me write it down formally. So if Fn and F are all functions that go from some domain D to R, and D is a subset in R, and all Fn are continuous, then we have, and Fn converges to F uniformly, then F is continuous. So we have a sequence of functions, it converges uniformly, all the functions which we have in that sequence are continuous, then the limit is continuous as well. I don't want to present the proof here, it is not so difficult, it is one of these proofs where you do this kind of three epsilon trick and in the end achieve the proof, but maybe that's not so important right now, or we can also put it as an exercise.